Hi everybody, so today I'm going to talk you through something that I get asked an extreme amount of times, being a spray tan trainer, on why am I going to stop working, my spray tan going to stop working, and also how to do a deep clean of my gun. You've obviously invested quite a lot of money in your unit, in your machine, your cubicle. It's really important that you keep on top of it and maintain the actual gun and the unit as well. So I'm going to first of all start off with the Sienna X. It is the true spray gun. So I'm going to do a deep clean now. So when you do a deep clean, well, I'd probably recommend that you do a deep clean, depending on how busy you are with your spray tanning. But if you're doing quite a few in a week, then it's always wise, maybe once a month, to take the whole of your gun apart and give it a real good clean. Now, we'd recommend probably just using antibacterial soap, just to give it a clean and a nice sponge. I just put everything into a bowl and just sit and just give it a good old thorough clean. Depending on how many you've done will depend on how dirty they are. Leave them all out to air dry. Leave all your parts out on a paper tissue or on a towel to air dry. I tend to do mine on a Sunday once a month so that I know that it's going to have the whole day to dry out. And then you can pop all your bits back together again and then you're good to go for the following week then. If you don't look after your machine, don't look after your gun, and it does suddenly stop working while you're in the middle of spray tanning, that would be the most horrendous thing for your customer and for you to experience the machine stopping. And you've spent hundreds and hundreds of pounds on these machines, so it's only wise to obviously look after them, and then they'll keep on working for you for a long time. So the first thing I'm going to show you with your true spray is the back here, which is where your nozzle goes into. You've got the dial here, and this is your density dial where you're going to turn that up and down to determine how much tan comes out of the front of here. So you're going to undo this. So if I turn it this way, you're going to totally unscrew it, and this is where your needle is going to come out. So as you see me unscrewing it, you can see it's actually coming further away from the machine. So keep unscrewing it. Hold it close so you can see. And you'll notice it does take quite a while to get the whole thing out. Don't do this over the top of a sink with the plug open, because you will find in a moment there's a little spring that comes out. So that's the density dial that's been undone from the back of the unit. So you're then left with that. So pop that into your little bowl. Take your screw out of the bowl, and you can then see the back of the machine. That is the back end of your needle. And the needle is extremely sharp, and you don't want to lose that or drop that onto the floor at all. So then, with your handle, your little handle that's here, push that back. And as you push that back, if I turn that back around again, that pops the needle out a bit further. So you can then pull this needle, give it a tug, and as you pull it out, that's what you're left with. So you need to make sure that you're very careful with that, because it's extremely sharp. And when you clean this, you'll take your sponge all the way along this and make sure that, because that can look quite greeny coloured. So pop that into your bowl. So back to your actual gun head. So you're now left, so you can see right through the inside of the unit there where the needle was. So that sorted out the needle bit. So now what you want to do is we're going to take this front bit apart. So you're going to unscrew the black outer case. Be careful, because the inside. So this is the direction of how the spray comes out. So you'll be left with that. Pop that into the bowl. And then you're left with just the silver. Take that off, which then looks like that. Pop that into your bowl. And you will have a little insert that's in there that you can take off as well. Okay, so, and apart from unscrewing the bottom bit of your unit, you can actually take that inside bit out as well. I'll show you that. So that's the inner bit of that. That all goes into your bowl along with the inside of this to give it a good clean. The rest of the unit that then's left, this can all just be cleaned over the top of with your antibacterial soap. So that's kind of all going to go into your bowl to give it a really good rinse through with your antibacterial soap. The only other thing that you've got to do as part of your deep clean is in your true spray small unit, your actual gun unit that you're going to plug the holes and everything into, if you look underneath the actual unit, you'll see a little trapdoor that looks like this. It's kind of like a little drawer, and you'll see it's got two little holes, and you'll need to stick a little knife or a screwdriver in, and when you pull, you'll end up with a little drawer that's like this. Inside that drawer, this is your filter. So if you pull your filter out from inside the drawer, that needs to then go into your bowl to be rinsed out as well, because if you haven't washed that at all, that will literally be sobbing wet with tan. So all that goes into your bowl. You're going to give it a really good clean over. It shouldn't be hard to take off, depending on if you've ever cleaned your unit before. But as I say, this is probably the biggest thing that I get messages through Facebook, through Twitter, through email saying, Caroline, my machine's not working, what's the matter with it? So this hopefully will help you. So give it all a rinse, and then we'll show you how to put it all back together again. Okay?